the situation, though, in Ferguson, we're going to see how this thing shakes out. Jay Nixon, the Democratic governor of Missouri, has just been stumbling, in my opinion. I don't understand the politics, and I'm not sure anybody does. I've not seen any good, clear analysis of this. And maybe you understand this. Maybe one of you who is watching knows this in a way that you can enlighten me. But why is a presumably decent Democratic governor bumbling this thing so badly, and has been almost from day one, and allowing the media to demagogue it? I mean, you know, it's really, I say really quite extraordinary way too much, but it really is. I just, you know, it's, and what Joe was saying about Juan Williams, you get these guys, you know, they start getting a paycheck from Fox, and all of a sudden it's like, whoa, look out. And what do we do about this? I think, you know, step one is we need to restore the economy of the United States and expand the middle class. Only this time, I mean, after World War II, we had a really significant economic expansion that theoretically lifted all boats, but African Americans were largely excluded from that by law. The GI Bill, you had African Americans coming back from World War II. My dad went to college on the GI Bill. He bought a house on the GI Bill. Had he been black, he certainly wouldn't have been able to buy the house, because the banks were legally enforcing redlining. Or if he did buy a house, he would have been very narrowly circumscribed in where and what house he could buy. And his ability to get into college would have been dramatically limited. I mean, keep in mind, this was even before Brown versus Board of Education. And so we had the experience in the United States, although the principal recipients were whites. There were some African Americans and Latinos and people of color who benefited from these things. But we had the experience. We know how to do this, of putting a country back together after a depression. Make the government the employer of last resort. Make your trade policies pretty rigid so that your manufacturers are keeping their manufacturing in the United States. Stimulate the economy significantly by building out infrastructure, from the intellectual infrastructure, which is free college, to the physical infrastructure like the Eisenhower Highway System. Now we could, you know, do internet. Back then it was the Rural Telephony and Rural Electrification Administration. Now it could be the Rural Internet Administration. I mean, there's so many ways. We know how to do this. And we can do it now in a way that benefits everybody. You know, as Franklin Roosevelt said, the best welfare program is a job. We need to bring the jobs home. And I realize, you know, the president supported this. Nancy Pelosi got it passed by the House of Representatives back when she was Speaker of the House. The Republicans filibustered in the Senate the American Jobs Bill that would have done away with the tax incentives to move factories overseas and provided tax incentives to bring them back home. We have to do that.